So last class we had arrived at equation 4, availability. Available energy. So what is availability and what is available energy? Available energy is the maximum useful work we can obtain from an engine, and availability is the maximum work done we can obtain from that particular engine. Okay, then the next topic is irreversibility. Irreversibility, I. So, irreversibility and availability is our major topic. So, irreversibility is nothing but defined as the difference between maximum work and actual work. It is defined as the difference between maximum work and actual work. Maximum work and actual work. So we can denote irreversibility I equal to W max minus W. W max minus W. So like availability, it is also have an equation for a non-flow process and a flow process. But here, equation for non-flow and a flow process is same. For irreversibility, the equation for non-flow process and flow process is same. So we can look what is the equation. So we have W max minus W here, right? W max is the availability, right? W max is the availability, maximum work done we can obtain. That is W max. W max is the maximum work done we can obtain in the case of no for flow process. W max is the maximum work we can obtain, and W is the normal work. That is normal work W for first law. We have studied that for first law, U1 minus U2 plus Q. U1 minus U2 plus Q is the normal work done, and maximum work equal to W max is the availability. This is equal to U1 minus U2 minus T naught into S1 minus S2. It is the change in availability energy. It is the second term is known as, it is totally called availability, and second term is known as change in availability. That is T naught into S1 minus S2. T naught into S1 minus, that is the particular called as unavailable energy also. This unavailable energy also, it is termed as the product of the atmospheric temperature T naught into change in entropy S1 minus S2. Okay, so W max equal to availability. This number kind of the equation on availability. For availability, we had write the equation as U1 minus U2, where process happening from 1 to 2. If process happening from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, we can write 1 to 0, 1 minus 0. Here, process from 1 to 2, U1 minus U2 minus T naught into S1 minus S2 minus W, right? Minus W. W is U1 minus U2 plus Q. Plus Q. Normal equation for first law. We have studied normal equation for first law. So here U1 minus U2 and minus U1 minus U2 will get cancelled. U1 minus U2 and minus U1 minus U2 get cancelled. And the remaining equation will be minus T naught S1 minus S2 plus Q. I equal to minus T naught minus S2 by 2. Or by removing the negative term, we can write it as negative. For removing negative, we can write it as S2 minus S1. Change the interchange the particular parameters S2 minus S2. Apply, we can remove the negative side S1 minus S2. S2 minus S1 mathematically, we can remove the item and we can write Q. That is, I is equal to T naught into S2 minus S1 plus Q. S2 minus S1 plus Q. So I am writing this particular equation in a particular form. Please understand. T naught into delta S, S2 minus S1, delta S of system, T naught into delta S of system plus T naught into delta S of surroundings. I am writing this Q as T naught into delta S of surroundings. So how I write a particular equation for Q as T naught into delta S So we know that delta S, that is change in entropy, ds, or delta S can be written as ds is equal to dq by t. Normal equation for our entropy is ds equal to dq by t. This is more a small process. dq by t is for a small process. So if we are considering the atmosphere for surroundings, or for whole process we are taking as delta S, that is ds of surroundings equal to 2 by surrounding means atmosphere. Surrounding means atmosphere. So atmosphere Q value will be capital Q divided by T will be atmospheric temperature T naught. Atmospheric temperature T naught. So ds equal dq by T. So I am returning as we are considering the surrounding temperature and surrounding entropy. We can write delta S of surrounding equal to capital Q divided by T naught. T naught means atmospheric temperature. Atmosphere atmospheric temperature. So here Q equal to, from here equation Q equal to delta S of surroundings, or ds of delta S is the same term, ds of surroundings into T naught. Ds surroundings T naught. So I'm substituting this equation here. Q, I am writing is Q as T naught into delta S of surroundings. So here T naught is the, again T naught is the. So we can take T naught as commonly outside, and we can write delta S of system plus delta S of surroundings. So I, we can write the equation for I equal to T naught into delta S of system plus delta S of surroundings. That is T naught is atmospheric temperature, delta S system is the system change in entropy of system plus change in entropy of surroundings. So all the, again we can write, yes, so it will change in entropy. Some mistakes here. I equal to I is always greater than or equal to zero. It will never be negative value. I will be always greater than or equal to zero, negative. So this equation I equal to T naught into delta system plus delta surrounding. So we can write T naught into S2 minus S1 plus Q. This is also an equation for availability. Irreversibility. And this is a major equation, I equal T naught into delta system plus surroundings. So this equation is same for non-flow process and a flow process. For all process and either non-flow process, the equation is same. Okay. This equation is same for, note that, same for non-flow and flow process. Non-flow and flow process, same equation is using for non-flow and flow process. That is the irreversibility. That is W max minus W. Maximum work done minus actual work done. Okay. Done. Then our next topic is effectiveness. Effectiveness of particular heat engine, effectiveness or available energy, effectiveness or availability, effectiveness. It is simply denoted as effectiveness is equal to useful work divided by maximum useful work. Useful work divided by maximum useful work, W maximum useful work. Useful work divided by W maximum useful work. It is also denoted as increase of availability of surroundings divided by loss of availability. It is defined as a ratio of actual useful work to maximum useful work. Useful work divided by maximum useful work is called effectiveness. Some problem is there in textbook related to effectiveness, so therefore I am writing this equation. There is no importance in your syllabus, but there is some problems related to effectiveness. The problem is to find out anything available energy or irreversibility, etc. But a C part will be asked to find the effectiveness. Either will be asked to find the effectiveness of particular engine, so we cannot ignore the particular effectiveness. So therefore I am writing this effectiveness. Again, it also can be written as increase of availability divided by loss of availability. Increase of availability. Increase of availability divided by loss of availability. Okay, effectiveness is also less, it is always less than unity. 0.0 to 0.9. That value will be between 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1. Between 0 to 1. And can be also, this also can be defined as the increase of availability to loss of availability. Other than W useful divided by W maximum useful, can be also defined as increase of availability divided by loss of availability. So I'm moving to a last topic, that is second law efficiency, and we can do a problem. thereafter we can do a problem related to irreversibility. So second law efficiency, we had studied about first law efficiency. First law efficiency you have studied. So here second law efficiency. Second law efficiency simply denoted by, what is first law efficiency? First law efficiency we can, we can simply write it as output energy divided by input energy. Output energy divided by input energy. Output divided by input is the normal efficiency. Normal efficiency we are using in the practice. Normally, we are using the output divided by input. That is our maximum efficiency, right? The particular efficiency we are using in the first law, or simply in thermodynamic condition, we are taking that output divided by input. So what is the efficiency in the case of second law? Second law, we have studied about available energy, entropy, etc., etc. We have studied. So what is the particular efficiency term related to second law? Second law efficiency means we are notated by efficiency 2. That is second law. Efficiency 2 can be written as, it is defined as the ratio of minimum available energy to actual available energy. Minimum available energy to actual available energy. Okay, guys. A minimum divided by A. It is defined as the ratio of minimum available energy. What is available energy? Available energy is the maximum energy, which we can convert, maximum energy which we can convert into work. Or availability is defined as the maximum amount of work we can obtain from a particular system. Okay, that is available energy. So here efficiency, second efficiency can be defined as the minimum available energy divided by actual available energy, A minimum by A. So A minimum by A, we can note A minimum equal to something W, and available energy equal to W max. What is available energy? Actual available energy is to like maximum available energy. Actual available energy, simple actual available energy means that it is a maximum amount of work done. Right? See, normal available energy can be denoted as it is a maximum amount of work done. So what is minimum available energy? Minimum available energy means simply work done. Not maximum, simply work done. So we can write relating to particular A minimum by A to work done. We can write it as A minimum to simple work done, and available energy as maximum work done. So we can also write this equation as W by W max. I will explain again. Minimum available energy means A minimum. Simple available energy means that maximum work done. Available energy, simple. Forget every. Only available energy is equal to maximum work done. Okay. Therefore, minimum available energy means normal work done. Normal work done. So we can write W by W max. W by W max. And another equation will also be another show, that is efficiency of first law divided by efficiency of Carnot. Sigma 1 divided by sigma Carnot. Sigma Carnot. That is a small derivation. We can write simply what is second efficiency means. We can write it as minimum available energy by actual energy, A minimum by A, or W by W max. Okay. Okay. So we can move to a problem related to irreversibility. So please write down a problem. So these are the topics. These are the theory topics in our third module. First, we have started from second law of thermodynamics. We had arrived about a Clausius statement and particular Kelvin-Planck statement. And we have studied the equivalence of Kelvin and Clausius statement. And we have studied about second law applied to non-flow process and a flow process. Study flow process and non-flow process. We had arrived at a particular equation. And we have computed the particular into the particular constant volume, constant pressure, constant, etc. In the case of entropy, we have arrived to a particular topic called entropy, and we have studied about what is entropy, what is change in entropy, and what is change in entropy in the case of constant volume, constant pressure, adiabatic, polytropic, and isothermal process. And thereafter, we have done a particular problem related to that, and we have moved to particular called available energy. Available energy, what is available energy, what is availability, what is irreversibility. That is the main topic in third module. Third module is a very compact module, but it's elaborating and topics are there. So you must be very careful by studying the third module, that main three portion is there. So don't skip any portion, because you have not, will not obtain by, you will not get more than one or two questions for the previous 2019 syllabus. So there is no previous question paper for you. So you cannot refer any previous question paper in the case of 2019 syllabus to skip and study. So you must be very careful by studying. So here we can do a problem related to reversibility. That is, 1 kilogram of air is right on a problem related to reversibility. That is, 1 kilogram of air. One kilogram of air is compressed polytropically. കൂടാതെ അടുത്ത മൊഡ്യൂളിലേക്ക് നമ്മൾ കടക്കുന്നു. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കയ്യിൽ വേണ്ട ഏറ്റവും മികച്ച കാര്യം, ദ വെരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് തിങ് യു മസ്റ്റ് ബി മുള്ളിയർ ചാർട്ട്, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് മുള്ളിയർ ചാർട്ട് ആൻഡ് സ്റ്റീം ടേബിൾ. മുള്ളിയർ ചാർട്ട് ആൻഡ് സ്റ്റീം ടേബിൾ ടു ഡു എ തേർഡ് ഫോർത്ത് മൊഡ്യൂൾ പ്രോബ്ലം, യു മസ്റ്റ് നീഡ് എ സ്റ്റീം ടേബിൾ ആൻഡ് മുള്ളിയർ ഡയഗ്രാം. ആസ് എ ടോൾഡ്, സ്റ്റീം ടേബിൾ ഇസ് ദി പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ സാച്ചുറേഷൻ value denoting table that will be available in every textbook of thermodynamics in last appendix as it is given, but you cannot take that textbook into your exam hall. So steam table will be obtained separately. It will be separately you will get an a Mollier diagram. Mollier diagram means simply a graph is entropy enthalpy diagram. Enthalpy, enthalpy and entropy diagram is Mollier chart. So it's like fourth module is denoting to problems related to Mollier chart and steam table. So if you study the particular Mollier diagram and steam table very thoroughly, you can do any problem with that. Okay. So here 1 kilogram of air is compressed polytropically from 1 bar pressure. From 1 bar pressure and temperature. 1 bar pressure and temperature of 1 bar pressure and temperature of 300 Kelvin to a pressure of 6.8 bar and temperature of 293 Kelvin. Assume R equal to 0.287 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. That is standard value of R. If it is not given, you can assume it. R value, Cp value equal to 1.005 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. That is also a standard value of air. If it is not given, you can assume it. And Cv is given here. Cv equal to 0.716 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. So here okay sorry, there is a mistake, sorry. So I will be very young to wait. You want to correct it. So 1 kilogram of air is compressed polytropically from 1 bar pressure and 1 bar pressure and temperature of 300 Kelvin. Okay, let's show 300 Kelvin to a pressure of initial condition of 1 bar and temperature 300 to a pressure of 6.8 bar and temperature of 370 Kelvin. Sorry, a line is missed here. So cut the angle, addition add here. Okay, ഒരു സിംഗിൾ ലൈൻ ഇവിടെ മിസ്സായി പോയിട്ടുണ്ട് അവിടെ വരുന്നത്. ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ലൈൻ ഈസ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഓഫ് 370 കെൽവിൻ. ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഓഫ് 370 കെൽവിൻ ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ദി ഇറിവേഴ്സിബിലിറ്റി ജസ്റ്റ് നോട്ടേഷൻ കൊടുത്താൽ മതി. ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ദി ഇറിവേഴ്സിബിലിറ്റി, ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ദി ഇറിവേഴ്സിബിലിറ്റി ഇഫ് ദ സിങ്ക് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ്, ഇഫ് ദ സിങ്ക് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ്, സിങ്ക് 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 ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ് 293 കെൽവിൻ, സിങ്ക് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ് 293 കെൽവിൻ ആൻഡ് അസ്യൂം ആർ ഈക്വൽ ടു ദെൻ ദർ ആഫ്റ്റർ ആർ ദർ ആഫ്റ്റർ ഈ ചെറിയ ലൈനും കൂടി അവിടെ ചേർക്കാം. ഓക്കെ, 1 kg ഓഫ് എയർ ഈസ് കംപ്രസ് പോയിട്രോപിക്കലി ഫ്രം 1 bar പ്രഷർ ആൻഡ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ 300 കെൽവിൻ. ഇനീഷ്യൽ കണ്ടീഷൻ ഈസ് 1 bar ആൻഡ് 300 കെൽവിൻ ടു എ പ്രഷർ ഓഫ് 6.8 bar ആൻഡ് 370 കെൽവിൻ. സോ ടി ടു എക്സിറ്റ് കണ്ടീഷൻ ഈസ് ആഫ്റ്റർ കംപ്രഷൻ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ് 370 ആൻഡ് പ്രഷർ ഈസ് 6.8. ആൻഡ് ടു ഫൈൻഡ് ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ദി ഇറിവേഴ്സിബിലിറ്റി, ഇറിവേഴ്സിബിലിറ്റി ഈസ് എ സിംഗിൾ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ് 293 കെൽവിൻ, സിംഗിൾ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഈസ് 293 കെൽവിൻ. ഓക്കെ, so given data sir, assume data sir, assume r equals 0.287 kJ, etc, etc. okay, so please note on the given data first. Given data, here T1 is given as 300 kelvin, 300 kelvin okay. And final condition P1 and T1 is 1 bar and 300 kelvin. And second condition, after compression, the second condition is P2 and T2 as P2 6.8 bar and T2 as 370 kelvin. T2 is 370 kelvin. And another again, single temperature is given. Single temperature also given. So here. It is compressing isotropically. It is process to compress polytropically, and the initial condition and final condition is given. T1 and T2 is given. So thereafter, sink temperature is also there. It is source is there. And thereafter, process happening polytropically. There is sink is there. So there are sink can be treated as atmosphere T naught. T naught. T naught is given as 293 Kelvin. സിംഗ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ മീൻസ് ലോവസ്റ്റ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ, ലോവസ്റ്റ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ. സോ വി ക്യാൻ ടേക്ക് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് അറ്റ്മോസ്ഫിയർ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ടി നോട്ട് ഇക്വൽ ടു 293 കെൽവിൻ. അല്ലേ, 273 മൈനസ് 273, 293 മൈനസ് 273 ഈസ് 20 ഡിഗ്രി സെൽഷ്യസ്. So irreversibility I equal to, you know, irreversibility to find values, irreversibility I equal to endana, I equal to first initial condition, initial equation W max divided by W max minus W actual or W, W maximum minus W actual. Irreversibility I equal to W maximum minus W. പ്രോബ്ലത്തിൽ നമ്മൾ ഇക്വേഷൻ ആണ് യൂസ് ചെയ്തത്. ഓക്കെ, ഡബ്ല്യു മാക്സ് മൈനസ് ഡബ്ല്യു, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഫസ്റ്റ് യു ഫൈൻഡ് ഡബ്ല്യു മാക്സിമം വാല്യൂ, ഡബ്ല്യു മാക്സിമം വാല്യൂ ഫസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഡബ്ല്യു ആക്ച്വൽ വാല്യൂ സെക്കൻഡ് ആൻഡ് ഫൈൻഡ് ദി ടോട്ടൽ. സോ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ഡബ്ല്യു മാക്സിമം ഈസ് അവൈലബിൾ എനർജി, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഡബ്ല്യു മാക്സിമം ഈക്വൽ ടു U2 മൈനസ് U1 മൈനസ് ടി നോട്ട് ഇൻ ടു S2 minus S1 or S1 minus S2, anything. If it is a higher value, we can take it as negative. It is reversible. It is compression process happening here. One clear means compressive polytropic. It is reversible process. That is this condition. 1 to 2. 1 to 2. Okay. 1 to 2 reversible. The figure is that this process happening 1 to 2, so it is taking reversible. It is compression. So if expansion is happening, you can take 1 to 2 here, 1 to 2 here. So it is compression. So 1 to 2, so higher temperature will be 2, higher temperature will be your second condition, higher temperature higher value will be your second condition. TS diagram, higher temperature and higher entropy will be a particular, higher entropy will be S1, and thereafter you can take that particular value second. You can draw that TS diagram as like this. So what is the U2 minus U1? Either U is not given. U is not given. U2 is not given. U1 is not given. S2 is not given, S1 is not given. So I will write a critical equation here. That is U2 for a particular, for a perfect gas, you know, U equal to CV into T. You know, we know U equal to CV into T, H is equal to CV into T, right? And U equal to CV into T. Therefore, U2 equal to CV T2. U1 equal to CV T1. It's a very important equation. You must be very thorough with this equation from the first module itself. U equal to CV into T. Therefore, U2 equal to CV T2. U1 equal to CV T1. Okay. So we can write the equation as W maximum equal to CV T2 minus CV T1. CV T2 minus CV T1. So CV is constant. So we can take either value CV as outside. CV as T2 minus T1. That is U2 minus U1 minus T0 into minus T0 into S2 minus S1 delta S. S2 minus S1. So L2 minus S1 for a particular process, for a total process. You can write S2 minus S1 as we have studied the change in entropy for a different process, right? Change in entropy for different process we have studied. For a particular process, for a total process, we have studied the what is the equation for S2 minus S1. Is I'm writing there are two equations are there. Anything you can do log T2 by T1 minus R log P2 by P1 is there. According to CP value, CPR, there are three equations, CP related to R, CV related to R, and CV related to CP. Three equations we had written for, but for a particular S2 minus S1 equation. S2 minus S1 equation, we had written three equations for relation with the CP and R, CV and R, CP and CV. You have written three equations. So anything you can take here. So here, it is taken as S2 minus S1 equal to S2 minus S1 equal to CP log T2 by T1, CP log T2 by T1 minus R log P2 by P1. And it's S2 minus S1. So here it is used as CP log T2 by T1 minus R log P2 by P1. So we have written, we have written this equation because other equations are related to volume is there. P, T and V2 by V1 okay. Actually equation is V2 by V1 okay. So here volume is not given. Volume is, volume, initial volume of phylum volume is not given here. So we are, we have, we cannot take that equation related to the volume. So we can write this equation that is T2 and T1 is given, P2 and P1 is given. And R we can find out by CV. CP minus CV equal to R. CP minus CV equal to R. So we can directly find the value of R. Or other, or R value is given in a problem, right? R value is given in a problem, 0.87. So all value is given here. So directly substitute the value to find the value of W maximum. That is this equation. CV is given as 1.005, sorry, 0.716, 0.716 into T2 minus T1. T2 is given as, T2 is given as 370. T1 is given as 300 minus T0. T0 is given as 293 into CP log T2 by T1. Because CP means 1.005 into log, natural logarithm. It is not log, it is ln. T2 by T1, 370 by 300, yeah, by 100 minus R. R is 0.287 into P2 by P1. P2 is 6.8, P1 is 1 bar. You don't want to convert the value because we are taking a ratio on it. Ratio on it. P2 by P1 is a ratio. So we can, we don't want to convert into Pascal or something. And then it is P2 is 6.8 divided by 1, P2 by P1. Either we are converting into Pascal value, that is 6.8 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. And we are either writing 1 into 10 raised to 5 Pascal. All values deleting. 10 raised to 5 is exactly, we are cancelling it because it is dividing. So we can use 6.8 divided by 1 itself, 6.8 divided by 1 itself. So please use a calculator to find the value, that is 0.716 into a particular value to find the W maximum value. W maximum. Only substituting the value, only substitute the particular values in your equation. We can find the value. So now time is up. So I'm writing this particular value. It is given as 149.53 kilojoule per kilogram. Will be in kilojoule per kilogram. 149.53 will be get. So this value will be negative. This value will be negative because work is done on air. Work is done on air. So you must be very careful by giving the signs because first process compression. Right? Compression. Compression means we are compressing that air. We are work is done on the air to compress. Then adichamarthana and then air in it to compress into high pressure and high temperature. Right? So work is done on air to compression. Expansion on the positive value. So it is indirectly we are pressing the or we are enforcing the air to compress. So your work is done on the air. So value will be negative. W maximum value will be negative. So maximum negative or go will you know. So there is no logic in that. There is no logic about maximum or minimum value. Only we correct work done when we get a value of work done, think that a particular how the work is done. It is to the system or by the system. If it is done to the system, it is negative value. The non-air, so get A is a negative. So next value is to find out W actual. W maximum is find out. So what is the W actual value for a work done for a polytropic process? So I think for the last class, we have done a problem using polytropic. For last class, we entropy. For entropy, we have done a problem using polytropic. We have done for polytropic, adiabatic, constant pressure and constant volume. A last problem. So please, page Marchumoki, in the equation alone. So for the I think we have studied for first module we have studied about work done for a constant pressure process, a constant volume process, etc. That is MCP T2 minus T1, MCV T2 minus T1, etc. We have studied particular equations. So we have studied for a polytropic and adiabatic same equation is there. One is PV raised to N and the other is PV raised to gamma. For polytropic, we have studied that W equal to MR T1 minus T2 divided by N minus 1 polytropic. If it is an adiabatic process, W equal to MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. T1 by T2 all raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma could rest PVT relations of it like PVT relations. That's a good idea. W equal to MR T1 minus T2 divided by gamma minus 1. So simple, simple. W actual value for a polytropic process. The equation is very chickling if the market butter like yoga. W equal to M into R MR T1 minus Q divided by N minus 1. So M is given in a question, that is M is 1 kilogram of air. 1 kilogram of air is given in a question. So M is equal to 1. R is given. T1 is given. T2 is given. So N is not given, right? So N is not given. So here only value to be find out is N value. N value. That is PV raised to N equal to constant N value. N value. So to find the N value, we can use a relation. Either temperature PVT relations is there. PVT relations is there. Pressure, volume, temperature relations is there. So we can use any one relation to find. So volume on the tail. So we cannot take the relation related to volume. U by VT equal to PT equal to raised to N minus 1. We cannot take that particular equation. So we can only take the equation related to pressure and temperature. So for N, we can take the equation as T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 whole raised to N minus 1 by N. This was the equation we had already written in notebook. For the last session, for last module, we have studied this question. T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 whole raised to. Here T2 is given, T1 is given. P2 and P1, P1 is only unknown value will be N. So here N will be N minus 1 by N can be written as, from this equation, N minus 1 by N can be written as natural logarithm T2 by T1 whole divided by natural logarithm P2 by P1. Okay, our relation on choka, either A by B. Or A equal to B raised to N minus 1 by N. We can write N minus 1 by N equal to log A by log B. either n is the n equal to log a by log b. Take logarithm on both sides and find the value of n. The equation is going to be, that is, take logarithm of log a equal to log b raised to n. Log b raised to n is n log b. So n equal to log a by log b. Okay, ingana varunathu log a. So we can convert this equation as log t2 by t1 divided by log of p2 by t1. So all the values given. Natural logarithm t2 by t1 370 by 300 divided by natural logarithm 6.8 divided by 1. So we can find out the value of n here directly. N minus 1 by n will be a value, and some other equation we can find the value, that is n equal to 1.123. 1.123 will be the value for n, and after finding the value of n, we can find the value of w actual as mr t1 minus t2. T1 is given, t2 is given, r is given, m is given by n minus 1. Calculate the value, that is 1 into 0.287 into t1 minus t2, that is 300 minus 370. 300 minus 370 will be a negative value. Right, 300 minus 3 will be negative value, so the equation will be a negative value. 1.123 minus 1. 300 minus 3 negative value, so whole value will be negative, that is negative 163.3 kilojoule per kilogram. Negative 163.3. Negative 163.3 kilojoule per kilogram. This is the equation. And then negative value, 300 minus 3 will be a negative value. So W actual kitty. W maximum and W actual is find out. So thereafter, irreversibility I equal to W maximum minus W actual, that is negative 149.53 negative value minus 163.3, right? Minus 163.3. Okay, so minus and minus will be a positive value. So minus 149.53 plus 163.3. Minus 145 is a small value. So total equation will be a positive value. That is I equal to 13.8 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, so please do it yourself after this class. Please take this as a practice and do this problem. And in your textbook, you can look more and more problem in your textbook for a practice. So this question is to find the irreversibility. Only thing you want to do for irreversibility is to find out the W maximum value and W actual value. W maximum will be also always a particular constant equation. That is particular equation for available equation. That is U2 minus U1 minus T naught into S2 minus S1. S2 minus equation karayam, and U2 minus U1 will be CV T2 minus T1. That's W actual value will be changing. That is for depending upon the process. This question is some polytropy process. Polytropy process, the equation is like this, MR T1 minus T2. If it is adiabatic process, the equation will be gamma minus 1. Gamma is 4 air, 1 minus 4, 1.4. If it is a constant pressure process, W value will be changing. If it is a constant volume process, volume will be changing. That is MCP T2 minus T1 or MCU T2 minus T1, etc., etc., etc. Okay, like that. The value will be changing. So that is all for today's session. So we can do one or two problems for the next class in the case of availability. For availability, we can do one or two problems for the next class, and we can wind up this session, this module. Okay.